your firm, okay? It has everything you need. You got 3 luxury cars you can sell to soccer moms. I put some, you know, good stock there, good market share, and also high debt for your stock firm, so you can buy some milk. You can ask one of the executives where to do that.
You remember your target market, high income and families? I wrote it down for you just in case. Put it on your dashboard. I don't want you to lose it. Are you ready?
I think so.
Don't f*** up.
I guess it's natural for firms to cry on their company's first day on the market, but that's usually when the firm is new. We are 16, and until today, our firm was not doing so hot until our new executives came on board. I know what you're thinking, we all are. Luxury car brands are f***ed, or something that we are too big for our britches.
And on the fifth period, God created Caliente, AEV, so that man could ride clean and in style. Oh man.
Where are you going?
Oh, I'm going to be the high-end car maker in the industry.
You need more development centers to do that.
Okay, well then can I have one more development center to increase our technological capabilities? Who are the plastics?
Oh, they're car industry royalty. If this was Monopoly, they would be the coveted Go space.
That one there, that's from A. She's one of the dumbest girls you will ever meet. Dodge sat next to them last year in stock price.
They asked me how to spell dividend.
And that little one, that's from B. They're totally killing it because their father invented the view. Firm B knows everybody's business. They know everything about everyone, probably from wasting all their money on competitive mapping tests.
Yeah, that's why their cumulative net income is so it's full of secrets.
And evil takes a human form in Firm D. Don't be fooled because she may seem like your typical low-styling, high-quality firm, but in reality, they are so much more than that.
They're the queen bee, the star. Those other firms are just their little minions for them to crush.
How do I even describe Firm D?
Firm D is flawless.
Firm D has 2 trucks and an AEV. Wow.
I hear they paid the big man upstairs, Dr. Colazzo, Timmy, and Darius, to help take over the market.
I hear they were always neck and neck with Firm C in marketing efforts. In Japan!
Their best car is their family car.
One time in period one, they almost tanked their company. It was awesome.
Wait, sit down. Why don't I know you?
We've rebranded. We used to be a chop shop factory in China.
What?
Our old execs didn't know how to run the company.
What?
We used to be a shitty ass firm.
No, I'm not retarded. So you've never been a real competitor before? Shut up. Chop Shop luxury car brand, huh? That's really interesting. OMG, I love your new AEV. It's adorable.
It's so fetch.
Oh, it's like slam from the test concept. So, if you're from China, why are you so expensive?
OMG, firm, and you can't just ask people why they're so expensive.
We just want to let you know. We don't do this a lot.
We want to invite you to be one of the big four every period for the end of time.
So we'll see you next period. On Wednesdays, we wear pink.
Hey, how was your second quarter?
It was fine.
Was production nice?
No, we were short sometimes due to miscalculating demand after we made improvements across the board.
Did you make any cumulative net income?
Yeah.
Run.
Two periods later, we made more improvements. Sales are increasing, yeah, but Firm C wanted to move faster, so we followed our instincts and we upped the advertising and promotion. Then, Firm D decided to enter into the AEV market. This started an all-out catfight between the firms.
Firm D is the nastiest. Copycat firm I've ever met. Do not buy AEVs from them. They're fugly.
commence the fall of Firm C in the AEV market.
Mom, can you pick me up? I'm scared.
Did you write this?
No, I swear.
Then you told somebody.
She told.
You little bitch.
You're a bitch.
I did not leave the South Side for this.
Oh, junior girls report to the gymnasium.
Raise your hand if you've ever been victimized by Firm D.
Shareholders, I'm sorry we tanked our stock that time the economy got diarrhea. And I'm sorry we couldn't recover from it until the very end. And I'm sorry for repeating it now.
I just wish we could all get along like we used to in middle school. I wish that I could bake a cake made out of rainbows and smiles and we'd all eat and be happy.
She doesn't even go here.
I'm sorry that people are so jealous of our sports car, but I can't help it that I'm the only one in the class.
Do you know what everyone says about your AEV? They say you're a knockoff luxury version of me, so don't try to act all innocent. You can take that reduced price AEV and shut it right up your...
Harry!
And that's how Firm D died. No, I'm totally kidding. They basically remained untouched. Some people swear they saw Firm D conspiring with similar firms in another class to take down Firm C, but that's just a rumor. Some consumers say they prefer Firm C because they stuck to their guns in trying to give high-income enterprisers, families, and the long-awaited singles what they expect, top-of-the-line cars. In case you were wondering, the plastics broke up. Firm D continued to take over the market in first, and more models were introduced to continue to allow them to pour their wrath in the marketplace. Firm A used their special powers to dominate the utility class.
Okay, ready?
You're right. Hi, this is Firm A. It's December 4th, and there's a 30% chance that our utility car is already being utilized.
And Firm B found themselves a new industry to join and a new queen bee to represent. As for Firm C, we still produce the Caliente along with all of our other models and continue to be a leader in the industry so we can still pay over $300 million in dividends with zero debt. We went from chop shop luxury cars to a leader in a new class, the most hated person in the world during the recession, to an actual stable Big Four competitor. All the drama in the last 10 periods just wasn't important anymore, as we have to look forward to continuing our success. Finally, the car industry was at peace. At least for a little while.